Good morning. As you know, we as a school solicited feedback from our community, including parents, educators, and students on the current dress code policy. We are grateful for a very high participation rate on our survey by parents, students, and faculty members. We have completed the final updated version of the new dress standard after analyzing the results from the survey, drafting a modified dress code based off of the data, discussing with our community council, with our school building committee, and our school leadership team. Norms and standards were identified from the data, and modifications to the dress standard were made based on what the majority of our community feels is adequate for a professional school environment. Students and parents will be getting an email with this information, including the data results from the survey. This email will also give you a chance to compare the prior dress code that has been in place for previous years with the new updated dress standard developed based on the previously mentioned process. While there are many parts that have stayed the same, there are a couple of changes I'll point out that were made based on feedback, survey data, and discussions with the community council, school building committee, and school leadership team. We have removed the language that speaks to the second dress code violations resulting in suspension and changed it to habitual violations will result in further disciplinary action, including communication with parents. We have also taken out some of the specific language regarding halter tops, spaghetti straps, tank tops, and replaced it with this non-gender specific image. This image simply identifies that all students, regardless of gender, are required to cover the area from armpit to armpit down to the mid-thigh. This means that tank tops will be allowed as long as they follow the guidelines in this image. We know that there are students, faculty, and parents that have strong opinions on all sides regarding school dress standards. The purpose of all these discussions and soliciting feedback is to create a standard of dress that maintains an environment conducive to learning and preserves the safety among all students. This process has led to a couple more flexible dress options for kids, such as the tank top or other tops that have straps as long as they follow the guidelines in the image. We understand that each individual person and family have diverse opinions on what is and what is not acceptable for dress standards in a school setting, including some extreme views on both ends of the conversation. It's virtually impossible to have a dress standard that we all will agree with, and we recognize the consensus of the data results does not and cannot represent all various opinions, and it is a general norm. Nonetheless, we are charged with determining a common standard that we expect everyone to follow. Thank you to all those who participate in this process, and thank you for adhering to our dress standard at Kearns High School.